You are beautiful, my sweet, sweet soul. You are beautiful, my sweet, sweet soul. You are beautiful, my sweet, sweet soul. And I'll sing again. You are so good to me. You heal my broken heart. You are my Father in heaven. You are so good to me. You heal my broken heart. You are my Father in heaven. You are beautiful, my sweet, sweet song. You are beautiful.
John 8:32-36. And you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. They answered him, "We are Abraham's descendants and have never yet been enslaved to anyone. How is it that you say you will become free?" Jesus answered them, "Truly, truly, I say to you, everyone who commits sin is the slave of sin. The slave does not remain in the house forever. The Son does remain forever. So if the Son makes you free, you will be free indeed."
Love for me. Sing a moldy oldie. It was written in the mid-1700s, and I got all kinds of notes, so bear with me. This was written by a fellow named Robert Robinson. Robert, as a young man, as a teenager, went to a George Whitefield sermon. George was kind of a big deal back then. And his intent was to ridicule it, and then he ended up being converted, which... pretty awesome. He wrote this hymn, Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing, at the age of 23, and was a minister throughout his life. But in the third verse, he kind of writes about, prone to wander, Lord, I feel it, prone to leave the God I love, and that was kind of his journey. His faith kind of, you know, I've read a bit about him, and it kind of became just an academic pursuit for him. So every wind of this and that and the other, by the end of his life, he kind of left Orthodox thought and went probably through several different denominations and had some not so great ideas. So there's a story about him towards the end of his life riding along in a stagecoach, sitting next to a lady who had a hymn book open, and she's showing him this hymn. And she's like, come, this is awesome. Like, this is... And he's trying to change the subject. He's like, yeah. And finally he says, Madam, I am the unhappy man who wrote that hymn many years ago, and I would give 1,000 worlds to enjoy the feelings I had then. So Corey was teaching our discipleship class earlier and put a little bit in here from Galatians 3, talking about threats to our freedom in Christ. And it says, you foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you? Did you receive the Spirit by the works of the law or by hearing with faith? Are you so foolish? Having begun by the Spirit, are you now being perfected by the flesh? And I thought that applied pretty well here. You know, we come into this and it's this emotional, faith-filled experience. But then if it just stops there and it just becomes this academic pursuit or just this thing that we do, this club that we joined, where are we going to end up? I mean, I don't know. Reading about this guy was a stark warning to me, I think, about how we can be so wrapped up in the flesh that we just ignore the spirit. So meditate on that with me as we sing this together. Come now, Fount of every blessing.
Come thou fount of every blessing, to my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me some melodious song, sung by flaming tongues above. Praise his name.
Verses 7 to 10. Who executes justice for the oppressed? Who gives food to the hungry? The Lord sets the prisoners free. The Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord raises up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. The Lord protects the strangers. He supports the fatherless and the widow, but he thwarts the way of the wicked. The Lord will reign forever. Your God, O Zion, to all generations, praise the Lord.
I see the King of
Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the
Chapter 7, 24 to 27. Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and acts on them may be compared to the wise man who built his house on the rock. And the rain fell, and the floods came, and the winds blew and slammed against that house. And yet it did not fall, for it had been founded on the rock. Everyone who hears these words of mine and does not act on them will be like a foolish man who built his house on the sand. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and slammed against the house, and it fell, and great was its fall.
Open up my eyes in wonder.
praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe, we live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe, we live for you. Oh, we live for you. Holy, holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show me who you are and fill me.
God, we come before you humbly now and just ask that you would make your presence known here this morning. That you would soften our hearts for the word that you have for us today. That that this wouldn't be just a thing that we do. That this life you called us to would be something real and genuine. A real faith. Help us, Lord. Build my life, Lord. I want to know you more. I want to serve you better. I want to worship you in spirit and in truth. I want to be set apart. I want to be winsome. I want this place to be a place that people come and actually feel like they can be here and be safe and be loved. Because you are a God who loves us and who desires our hearts. A God so big, a God so mighty, a God so powerful who knows me and wants to be known by me. I want to know you, Lord. Help us this morning. Hear our prayers, hear our praises. Speak to our hearts and minds through the word that Pastor Sean is going to share with us. Let's just sing that, I Will Build My Life, one more time.
I will build my life upon.